So hi guys, and today we are going to talk about a very important course, and that is the biology course from MIT. So let me start by opening the website. So here we come to the website. Now let me just go to the MIT course number. Now for biology we have the course number is 7. Okay, so all the 7 courses will be there. So there are many various courses. Actually, there are a lot of courses here, but I'm not going to discuss every course because most of them are not relevant for us, and some of them are really outdated because they're old. Okay, so but we will talk about the initial few courses. Okay, so let me select only the video lectures in which I have we have those available. Now these systems biology, these are advanced courses, and these are actually physics courses. They come under 7 series because it's biology, but the information covered there is not biology, that is actually physics. And the biological chemistry I have discussed about that course. Some brief introduction I have given, and that I gave it in another video. So that was, I guess, about in the Harvard biochemistry video. Okay, so let's see the courses now. The most important course here is 7.1 SC, because this course is connected to the rest of the courses. There is a new course on COVID-19, SARS-CoV-2. You can do that also. I'm not going to review it because I haven't done it yet. So let me go to the fundamentals of biology. I actually did this course when I was in school, and this helped me a lot. So there are many sections here. Now what the thing is that the course in US, they are mostly based. Wait a minute, I guess there's some issue. Yeah. So the course which are in USA, they are mostly based on the genetics and the modern science. Basically, what is common within all the organisms rather than diversity. I will show you another course of biology which covers the diversity part also, but not now. I will show you that in another. I will show you that in some other videos. But today we are going to talk about the fundamentals of biology. Now, the special thing about this course is that this course covers only those topics which are co common among all the systems. Okay, whether we are talking about humans or plant or microscopic systems. Okay, and some advanced features also. So this is the first course, the fundamentals of biology. This is the SC course, and there are many different other versions, and there is an edX version too. So we will cover all of them. So let's first see the fundamentals of biology. Now let me see first of all what is the syllabus. Okay, from the syllabus we just need to see the book, and I don't think they have mentioned any book, but yeah, they have mentioned actually Campbell's Biology. I have read this book. This is actually an amazing book, and not just MIT, but other courses also uses this book only. Okay, Campbell's. So there are many different lectures. One is the biochemistry. So in biochemistry, this is taught by two different faculties, and actually three different faculties. Then we have molecular biology also. So this all stuff, let me show you some more things. So if you go to any page, so you will find the lectures, and the lectures are divided into different excerpts, and there will be some practice problems with every session. And there are some more questions, and these practice problems are really good. I did solve them, and there are some other links also that you can see for any animations, or if like there is a Nobel Prize given in physiology or medicine on this topic, so they have mentioned about that too. Okay, so that's why this is one of the best courses of biology available on the internet. Okay, the thing is that the course is a bit old now, but I'll show you a bit a newer version also. So do we have anything more? Yeah, so now let's see about these courses. So this covers biochemistry, molecular biology, genetics and recombinant DNA. And most of the genetics and recombinant and molecular parts, most of the subject is covered by Dr. Professor Eric Lander. Okay, now this is he's an amazing professor, really amazing. There are many things which are not covered here. I will show you those topics too, and they are covered in some other lectures. Okay, some other versions. So let's see the 7.012 2004 version. This is also an amazing version. Okay, it keeps shifting. Yeah. So the study material and exam and assignment, you can do assignments and exams from every version, and all are great. They're really good, mind-boggling questions are there. So they're really helpful. Okay. Now this version is one of the best versions actually. This is a very old version, around 2004. And the molecular biology, it has become more advanced since then, much more advanced. The professor Steven Weinberg he's an amazing professor. His lectures are amazing, and Eric Landry, his lectures are also amazing. So this part, the genetics part, this is actually pretty around more than 100 years old. So this part is won't be much different, but the other parts like molecular biology, molecular medicine, this stuff will be a little different. And I will tell you about another course where this stuff can be studied properly, okay? In this seven version, in seven series only, okay? So this one is a bit old, so you actually not required to do it from here. But yeah, the nervous system is amazing. The nervous system is not covered anywhere else in 7O series. I guess it is in 7 2000. I guess it is covered in 7014. I don't remember. We'll see it. But the nervous system covered here by Eric Lander is amazing. So two lectures are from Eric Lander, and the one lecture is from a Harvard guy. And this is one of the best. Like, I have studied this nervous system, this stuff from Dr. Najeeb also. And this lecture is better than Dr. Najeeb's. This is the clarity is so high. You know, actually, Dr. Eric Landry, he was actually a mathematician, and he did his PhD in mathematics in from Oxford. But now he's working in genetics with MIT. So you can see that this guy is really diverse, kind of like me. So let's see another version. So, okay, this is the old version. Yeah. So let's see another version. Now let's see the 2013 version. Okay, now this is, I guess, this doesn't have any video lecture. I guess, yeah. So this is one of the latest version taught in 2018. It doesn't have those video lectures, so we can just use it for study material. Okay. Well, the study material is actually Campbell's Biology. You don't need any PPTs or here. Okay. But the assignments are good, so you can do these assignments, and there are exams, study material, right? Are there any study material? Good. Yeah. So they have given you some stuff that some extra material they are given. You can study, but actually, when you will be doing, if you actually touch Campbell, then this stuff is way more than what is actually required. Okay, so I would suggest you to do Campbell's Biology. Now, this 7.013, this is the 2013 version. That was 2018, which was the latest. This 2013 version, I guess, this one is like, I guess, one of the best one. This one not the best. The best one I told you, but this one has some other stuff which I really like. So there are the video lectures. Now this only has some lectures. So yeah, we have the neurobiology lectures, but this neurobiology lectures are not that good. Means the information covered is more in these lectures, but the conceptual clarity is better with the Eric Landers version, the 2004 version. Okay, now this cancer biology, there are three lectures on cancer biology, and this is, I guess, one of the best parts about this course. We have a new series also. We have a new playlist created by MIT on biology only, and I guess they also have covered a lot of cancer. But I like the Jack's lectures and Tyler Jack's, and I guess the professor now teaching was actually a student of Jack's, and I really love these lectures, the cancers. Even today, I have studied a lot about cancers in lot about in lot book in lot of books and lo by a lot of lectures. But these Tyler Jack's lectures made a great foundation, and I uses its diagrams in my professional examination of MBBS actually. Yeah, and that's why I think I didn't get a good score, and the results have not come yet. But I don't think they will give me good score. Okay, but in third semester I didn't get good score. Now let's talk about. So this one, another this is another version. This is quite older version. This is an older version, and I guess there is nothing special about this version. So, yeah, there is something that is the epidemiology part, the productivity and food webs and productivity. This stuff is covered here, like population growth and epidemiology basically. So epidemiology is not covered anywhere else. So that is the good part about this course. But I will tell you another course which covers this information with much more clarity and much more interesting. Okay, so you will love that course where I will teach tell you about that. Okay, so we have to wait for that. Now let's come to a more advanced version, and that is the edX version. So let me go there. Hello, let's wait. Internet's not working, it's slow. Okay, here is it. So this is the edX version. Okay, so this is actually a bit pretty new course. Not new actually. This actually is not updated. The lectures are not yet updated. They were shot, I guess, in 2013, and they are still there. But the pattern of the course and the information they keep editing that. So that's why the course becomes a pretty updated course. Okay, so it's not outdated. The other ones are outdated. So let's see. Now, if you want a certificate, then you can purchase a certificate. Now, I live in India, so therefore it's $11,000. We'll see. So let me first just order the course, because we don't need any certificate. So here you will see about the money in dollars. It's waiting. Okay. So we have how much? We have $127. So you can purchase it for $127. But of course, if you don't want a certificate, then you can just use the audit version. Okay. So all the basic lessons are covered here. Now this all part is amazing. That is the cloning and the human genome part. Now, and the observing and pretubing genome to probe function. This stuff is amazing. I really like this course, and the lectures are pretty long here. Like I guess one of these lectures is actually a 72 minutes long lecture. None of the other seven series versions courses has a lecture which is this long, but this one has it, and it's really interesting about when you study about the jumping genes, and also you study here in a much more depth. And then this part, disease and the science society. Now here also we have cancer biology. Now this cancer biology is little bit different than what we saw in, or what you will study in Tyler Jack's lectures. The Tyler Jack's lecture is actually much better than this one, but you can actually study this also. There is no harm. And then this part is really amazing. I love this part, and this is the DNA and the law part. Okay, this actually covers a lot about the forensic part, like how does DNA fingerprinting. Now DNA fingerprinting is not covered. That is covered above here. But how it is actually used, and basically it is not used, and that is what you will see in this section. Okay, anything else I need to cover? So let me see if I have told you about everything. Now, are these courses difficult? Basically, if you are in schools, if you're just a schooler and not in college, then these courses are going to be a bit difficult for you, and a lot of material will be covered here which you actually don't require. And they are unique because the stuff is directly from USA. So if your country is not, if you are in a developing countries, then the courses are still ahead of you. Okay, but do you need to make notes? Now the answer is yes. Whenever you see lectures from this course, this is important that you should have a notebook with you and pen. And because most of the lectures are not PPT based, most of the lectures are whiteboard or pen or blackboard and chalk versions. Okay. So it is important that you do make notes and do solve the question. Now this also has some interesting, you know, about Anki decks like that. So here we do not have an Anki deck, but here we have a Cerebo memory thing here. Okay, so that works like a deck. So it is going to ask you a lot of questions about the subject, and it will help you learn the stuff. Okay, so that's why I like this course. This Cerebo memory set, I was introduced to this by this course, and this helped me a lot. Okay, anything else? Other options? Well, there are other options, and I will cover about other biology courses. Now, when I used to be in school, then there were more courses than what are available now. Now, actually, there are more available courses now, but when I was in school, then really great courses were there from University of California, Berkeley. But now they have removed those courses. So they are in the archive section, and I'll show you how you can go there in some other videos. And they are also great. And we have advanced lectures. Like this, most of the stuff covered here is molecular biology. But we have separate courses on molecular biology also, again by MIT. So I will cover them in another video. Okay. So I guess you love this video, and I'm sure you are liking this series of me introducing you with these international courses. So okay, tell me in the comment section if you want courses on some particular subject, and I'll see what I can do. And thank you guys for watching this video. And if you want to know about more about these such courses and want to get updated about what new courses are there in the world, then don't forget to subscribe. And God bless you.